And now we have the last presentation. I would like to invite Professor Ganna Doroshenko from Karazin, Kharkiv National University. 3 years ago, I visited the university and I was impressed because of research achievement. Your university has more Nobel Prize winners than all Polish universities. 3. Okay, the title of the paper is Effective Corporate Governance as the Basis for the Growth of Enterprise Value.
Thank you, and a couple of words for organization and colleagues. Вас ще чеше, що ми були учасниками так важного подорожання, значатися не тільки для учасників конференції надзор корпораційний, є і повічна відповідальність ще бізнесу, має значення не і сповічна відповідальність бізнесу у Японії, але означення міжнародове. Дійшла дискусія на тему загадних зв'язаних зі специфіком владу корпораційного, культури корпораційної і сповічної відповідальності бізнесу, має значення для іншощих країв. І базо символічна є, що дискусія на цей темат має місце в краю, який не тільки знайдується в центрі інтеграції культур, традицій, подич наукових і адміністраційний, але має також огромний потенціал і досвідчення в впровадженні відомих технологій і метод зажудзання. В імені власним ураз декана відділу економії Харківського університету новоградового імені Василя Каражіна виражаємо вдячність за можливість комунікування чи презентування наших помислів в дочерченце впливу владу корпораційного на вартість фірми в пентних мурах відділу економічно-соціологічного університету Гуцького. І ще раз дякую і життя нам всім полезної праці. Thank you. I have many papers because its work is reflected of scientific contradiction of its authors. I like to work with NPV and Dr. Oleksandr Davydov prefer to use added value. But I cut this work and I will be short. Let's start. Так, we spoke about corporative etiquette, about such opinions about governance of enterprise, but I will talk about assessment. And the gatekeeper who knows the price better rather than a manager or a appraiser. However, we are going digress from the current valuation of assets and company and focus on the valuation mechanism itself and the impact on corporate decision and conflicts on the value of the economic entity. For weak economies, including Ukraine, this is a very scientific issue which was formed at the center of contradiction at the macro and the micro level. In our study, we related to work and approaches of different scientific schools, and this is especially worthwhile to highlight. In our work, we relate to concept of value enterprise in a broad sense. Value is a characteristics of production process encapsulated in the economical well-being, which expresses its internal potential ability to bring effect and exceeds not only the cost of creating the benefit, but also the opportunity value. This approach cumulated the interpretation of many economic schools. Thus, enterprise value can be defined as an objective value that reflects the value of the enterprise as a specific product for a potential buyer and it's formed on a certain date in an economic environment using accounting the management information to make the purchase and sell transaction possible on the open market. The most widely used concept of market value, which means the most likely price at which a given object can be eliminated on the open market in a competitive environment when the parties to be transaction act reasonably with all necessary information and extraordinary circumstances do not affect to the amount of the transaction price. However, in a modern economic condition, the market value of an enterprise is a target value. In value management system is characterized by low objectivity when reflected in value forming processes. Market value is a current indication of the value of the enterprise, weakly correlated with the strategic vector of the development, and does not take into account the interests of many stakeholders except for the owners. The overwhelming majority of also distinguish this factor of influence of value, internal, external, macroeconomic and microeconomic, financial and non-financial, material and intangible. Analyzing the influence of factor, we propose to divide them into two groups, generated and destroying. The generating factors are combination of condition, parameters and circumstances then contribute to the effective functioning of enterprise growth, its competitiveness and synergistic effect in a combination of assets and liabilities and stimulate the growth of enterprise value in general. Value-destroying factor is a certain circumstance that worsens the stability of the enterprise, reduces its profitability, makes it impossible to build an effective system of management, assets and liabilities, and have a negative effect to the value of value indicators. Factors influencing the value can perform it according to the three classification groups: time, risk, and value. All of them are divided, taking into according characteristics, features of influence is value. Its factor is presented on this slide. Considering this value management means managing value factor, five components of definite. Value thinking of process of strategic planning, operation planning for enterprise value management, management of key value drivers, the system of motivation which establishes the connection between the rewards and achievement of targets value, and means of communication with the stakeholder. That is the creation of specific form of reporting related to the management of the value of the enterprise. The interaction of the mechanism of appraising the value of a joint stock company will with other mechanism is presented on this slide. According to the data, it can be seen that is both external and internal factors and mechanisms influence the forming of the formation of a mechanism for assessing the value of the joint stock company. The value of a company is a system of characteristics reflecting its ability to generate values for a wide range of consumers of the result of its operations. The value of the company is connected not only with the financial and economic indicators of its operation, but also with the company role in the social economic development and of the region and the state, the society as a whole. The main stakeholders are the owners, managers, creditors, suppliers, buyers, staff, and state. Conflict of interest of stakeholder leads to disharmony in the relation between them, have a negative reflector in the stability and efficiency of the enterprise, significantly complete the process of creating its value. In such conditions, the problem of harmonization, balancing the interest of stakeholder through managerial influence is performed in the activities of enterprise. As a result, social responsibility of the organization is formed. In fact, management is transformed on the basis of taking profit into management on the interest of stakeholders through their harmonization. Its approach is especially actualized in value-oriented management, and social responsibility is an element of forming of positive corporate reputation, which in turn can significantly increase the value of the enterprise itself. It is regard, in this regard, it is necessary to introduce the concept of fundamental stakeholder value into scientific use as a new type of manageable value within the framework of VBM concept. Fundamental stakeholder value is enterprise represents the aggregate value and expresses the integral assessment of the result of the financial and economic activity of the enterprise and explained the benefit of all its stakeholders in the area of realizing the possibilities of the long-term development. The fundamental stakeholder value is characterized with such essence. Fundamental stakeholder value is a reality property, that is, this value expresses the true value created in the real economy sector, and it is a cumulative result of targeted activities of the enterprise. Such a goal setting in the management of enterprise allows to include organically not only the fundamental process of operation, investment, and financial development of enterprise, but also relation with all those interested in its effective functioning in the value management system. Fundamental stakeholder value is expressed as value added. Value added is the value created directly by the enterprise in the process of products and goods, service, works, using human labor and added to the cost of intermediate consumption and together with all other forms of value of the manufactured product. The added value mainly included two structural components: payment for wage to employees who take part in the production, and added value profit in the of the enterprise. Conclusion. The choice of indicator of assessing value in individual of nature is the specific characteristic of objective and appraisal and the tactical and strategical objective of appraisal. Use of balanced system of assessment indicator should be the basis of making management decision. The realization of the stakeholders' interest is associated with the distribution of the added value of the enterprise when each of the stakeholder groups satisfy its own interest at the expense of the relevant part of this value. Management is transformed on the basis of taking profit into management of an interest of stakeholders through their harmonization. This establishes effective processes of harmonization in the distribution of profit contributes to the growth of the value of the enterprise. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. We have 7 minutes for discussions. Question?
Thank you for your presentation. I've got one question indirectly connected with the presentation. About your opinion, if Ukrainian corporate governance system is stakeholder or shareholder oriented, and why?
Unfortunately, in our country, for my opinion, we have a shareholder environment. Because, the first, in our country isn't assessment interests of state buyers and other participants.
I had one question, quite simple, but a little bit provocative as well. Could we get rid of all more or less sophisticated methods which are used to evaluate the quality of corporate governance standards and just assume that if a company is generating shareholder value, if its market value is growing, it means that such company implements good or even the best corporate governance practices. Can we assume that it doesn't matter what is the board composition, what is its independence, how top executives are awarded, how transparent a company is, only shareholder ability to create shareholder value matters?
Thank you. If you if you tell about our country and our practice, we can see what stakeholder very often started a squeeze out procedure for have a big influence for the politics of enterprise.